He was the last hero of the resistance, and France has not forgotten its debt. Hubert Germain was born in 1920 and was the son of an army general. Like his father, he hoped to have a military career. But as he sat his entrance exam in 1940, the Nazi army was closing in, and Germain took a dramatic step.
I'm taking this entrance exam, and if I pass it, I'll become a French naval officer taking orders from the Germans. It was against my morals and my family's morals. I got up and gave my blank sheet of paper to the supervisor. He looked at me like I was mad and said, "But you have 5 more hours." I told him, "It's no use. I'm going to war."
Aged just 20, he travelled to London, where he met General Charles de Gaulle and joined the Free French Forces. Germain fought in the Battle of Bir Hakeim in Libya and in the Battle of El Alamein in Egypt, before being wounded in Italy. Decorated with the Liberation Cross by General de Gaulle, once the young soldier was healed up, he was back in action and landed in Provence in France in the summer of 1944, after 4 long years fighting across the world.
Quand je suis arrivé sur la plage.
When I arrived on the beach, as I waited for my men, I walked 12 meters when I lost all strength in my legs and collapsed into the sand, bowed my head and cried like a child.
Hubert Germain died at the age of 101 last month. He was the last surviving member of the Order of the Liberation, created to honour 1,038 French World War II heroes. Germain's final resting place is with his comrades at Mont Valérien, a cemetery dedicated to resistance fighters near Paris.